Well, hello, everybody, and welcome to the Kahn Chronicle. I'm Joel Kahn, MD, a triple board certified cardiologist, and thank you for joining me on this news and informational show on health and wellness and lifestyle. We're going to go over four new and exciting articles that I think will have an impact on your health. And let's start, of course, with a fun fact. We talk a lot about arteries at the Kahn Chronicle. Arteries are lined with an endothelium that's covered with something called the glycocalyx. What plant-based substance can make the glycocalyx and your arteries stronger? And it's only a plant-based substance, so stay tuned to the end of this episode of the Kahn Chronicle and find out what plant-based food that is. So let's get going. If you remember, we're going to go head on over to drjoelkahn.com. And there we have it. And we're going to look over at the Kahn Chronicle, which is updated every day and many times a day so that you have the most up-to-date health news that you can use in your life. And we're going to pick several studies here. And one of them has nothing to do with plants directly, but everything to do with health. A brand new and interesting study found on my Twitter feed, at DRJKAHN, is a study that is in press, meaning it's the most recent and up-to-date science, looking at the impact of hand washing and the risk of getting viral infections. Now, we hope that our whole food plant diet is doing a remarkable job of making our immune system strong. But we have to remember the physical aspects to ensure that we don't catch colds and even more serious viruses. So in this study, where they were able to examine between 2006 and 2009 in England, the rate of catching coronavirus and influenza virus, this was another version of the coronavirus, they found that washing hands 6 to 10 times a day lowered the risk of seasonal influenza virus. There was 1,633 participants in this study. They were adults, and they found you could lower your risk by about 30 to 40% if you are willing to wash your hand 6 to 10 times a day. So you got to ask yourself, you're exercising, you're sleeping, you're eating salads and oatmeal and bean soups and making homemade bean burgers, but are you washing your hands regularly? Such a good habit in the morning through the day. So what are the takeaway points? The takeaway points are, number one, it's the frequency of hand washing that will help protect your health. Number two, it's the duration of hand washing that will help protect your health. And finally, it is the context. It is, are you coming in from outside? Are you coming in from a store? Are you coming in and going to prepare dinner? These are certainly the special times. You want to focus on a good 20-second hand wash. Remember, you sing happy birthday to you, happy birthday to you, all the way through. That should take you to about 20 seconds. Simple tip from the Kahn Chronicle, hand washing 6 to 10 times a day. Please share that with your loved ones so they have the same habit and can benefit in terms of the same health. Let's go back now to the Kahn Chronicle for another article and informational wellness post that you can enjoy. And we're going to look at one that's close to me because I wrote it. And in a online journal called The Beat, there is an article, The Big Fat War is Over. Saturated fat causes heart disease, says Dr. Joel Kahn. And it says here indeed that after 50 years of science indicating that saturated fat-rich foods like butter, cheese, eggs, meats, poultry, pork, baked goods that have butter and lard like croissants, all are associated with increased risk of heart disease, and this was very strong science from all over the world, starting, as it says, in 2010 and 2014, we got the Butter is Back movement. We got the dairy industry funding research studies, funding speakers, funding influencers, and creating confusion. But what happened? What are we talking about now? Well, there is an organization called the Cochrane Library and the Cochrane Database Review. And they just published an analysis of 16 high-quality studies, 59,000 subjects, looking at the relationship between intake of dietary saturated fat, butter, cheese, pizza, lard, baked goods, chicken, red meat, white meat, pork, fish, and the development of cardiovascular disease overall, heart attacks, strokes, aneurysms, death. And they found that if you reduce the intake of your saturated fat, you lower your risk of cardiovascular disease significantly. This wasn't borderline. They judge that if you would just lower your fat for about 2 years, your saturated fat particularly, you could dramatically drop your risk of cardiovascular disease. If you nearly cut out your saturated fat, no meat, no chicken, no pork, no cheese, no bacon, no hot dogs, no pepperoni, and maybe no coconut oil and palm oil, you can drop your risk of cardiovascular disease even more. These have been the saturated fat wars since 2010. But I'm pleased to announce that I think I'm the first credible physician and researcher in the country to jump on this data and make it absolutely clear that it took 10 years to end the arguments, but the arguments couldn't be more obvious. It is not healthy to pack your diet with saturated fats. Avoid, beware, try and cook either with plant-based oils, which in many of these studies were a major advantage over saturated fat from animals, or cook without oils, which many people do successfully. So look into that some more, and I'm glad that you can share the idea that the saturated fat war is over. So let's just talk for a minute the takeaway points. Number one, saturated fat increases your blood cholesterol. Number two, saturated fat is found almost exclusively in animal foods, and we have to throw in coconut oil and palm oil. And number three, reducing saturated fat will reduce your risk of developing cardiovascular disease. That's important information you want to share. All right, we're going to go ahead now and have a little fun with a completely different topic, and one that we don't typically do here at the Con Chronicle, but if it's credible news, there's no reason we can't. We're going to talk for a minute about wine, and we're going to talk about an interesting grape that's written up here in a journal called Wine Folly. And maybe you enjoy wine, maybe you don't. The grape is called Tanat. It comes from a village in southwest France near the Bordeaux region and other regions. But you probably haven't heard of Tanat. And let me say this. People that don't drink shouldn't start drinking because of anything I'm talking about right now. People that enjoy a glass of wine a few times a week are in a groove, are in that sweet spot that many research studies say is associated with health and longevity. It's common in the blue zones to have wine in the Mediterranean diet, for example, red wine usually. But Tanat is a special grape because Tanat is the highest concentration of a type of antioxidant polyphenol called procyanidins. And the Tanat grape has more procyanidins than any other. Now, it can be a little challenge to find the Tanat grape from France. Fortunately, Uruguay is also making wines from this grape that they grow in Uruguay, and they can be reasonably priced around $15. I've actually been able to find a bottle around $10 just to try this interesting grape. So it is something for you to, you know, consider as a little pearl, a little information that you might find enjoyable in a social setting when you're appropriately distanced. And you can see they describe the flavors of the Tanat grape with a combination of a black plum flavor, a black licorice flavor, dark chocolate, cardamom. It's a very deep, deep red and not very sugary wine. It's a very healthy tasting wine. So you might enjoy it. So what are the takeaway points? Number one, don't start drinking if you don't drink or if you have a health reason why you shouldn't drink. Number two, in many studies, a glass a few times a week of red wine is associated with a benefit. And number three, the Tanat grape joins a few others like Cannonau grapes from Sardinia and Pinot Noir grapes that may have extra protective chemicals called polyphenols and procyanidins compared to some of the other grapes. Go for low sugar, low alcohol wines. That's the classic table wine you'll find in the Mediterranean region. And it's a good habit for you to adopt also if you're going to enjoy a bottle of wine now and then. All right, we're not done yet. Remember, this is the Con Chronicle, founded drjoelcon.com. If we head over there for a minute, it'll update itself for a moment, and we'll be right back for the fourth and final article that we're going to discuss today from drjoelcon.com. Over to the button that says Con Chronicle, And finally, it'll take us to the article we want. Let's talk about hemp. And we're specifically going to jump over to Dr. Joel Kahn, and we're going to get right on over to hemp hearts. Do you know hemp hearts? Do you eat hemp hearts? Are they part of your diet on a regular basis? All about hemp hearts from The Leaf Online. So, you know, you might say, I know about chia seeds and I know about flaxseed and ground flaxseed. I'm not that familiar with hemp hearts. Well, you can go to any grocery store online or brick and mortar and buy a big bag that says hemp hearts. It might say hemp seeds because actually hemp hearts are hemp seeds. They're growing from the plant directly into production to dry them out and package them for you. What's so special about hemp hearts? They're totally legal in every state. They're not associated with any THC or hallucinogenic effect. And the only thing they share is that they come from a plant that, if grown in a certain way, can also create cannabis, but they are not the cannabis plant. They are amazingly high in protein. If you want to add some protein to your diet, all you got to do is sprinkle some hemp hearts on a salad, on a soup, on a smoothie, on oatmeal, delicious, crunchy hemp hearts. But they're particularly noted for their high concentration of alpha-linoleic acid, ALA, which is an omega-3 fatty acid that we need for health and metabolism and brain function and brain growth. So it's great to give children. Make them a little parfait with hemp hearts. Of course, do it from a plant-based milk. That would be the healthiest way. And there's also a lot of vitamin E, magnesium, phosphorus, potassium, iron, zinc, and B vitamins that you can find in hemp hearts. They are a powerhouse. It's nice that this article goes on to have some recipes like hemp heart and banana muffins, like a vegetable bowl with quinoa grain and hemp hearts, like veggies, pita, and hemp hummus. That sounds delicious. Spaghetti and hemp meatballs, hemp tabbouleh, and chia pudding with hemp hearts. I bet your mouth is watering by now, because those actually do indeed sound absolutely delicious. So what's our takeaway as we finish up here at drjoelkahn.com and stop the share? What's our takeaway points? Number one, hemp hearts are a very rich source of protein. Number two, hemp hearts are a very rich source of omega-3 fatty acids, which are very healthy for you. And finally, hemp hearts are full of fiber. They're going to support a healthy microbiome or your gut bacteria that is so important right now when we focus on immune health. You want omega-3 foods to have proper immune function, and hemp hearts are easily available in the store. Please go search them out, try them. I would think that about every day I have hemp hearts on top of one of my meals, one or two times a day. So we're going to wrap it up with the fun fact. Remember the question? It was a little sciencey. Every artery 50,000 miles in your body is lined with the endothelium and covered by a slime layer called the glycocalyx. What plant food can increase the strength and the protective nature of the glycocalyx? The answer is green seaweed. Green seaweed, actually, there's no other known plant source and there's no animal source that's known to strengthen this interesting layer of your artery. You could definitely trump almost any physician with now knowing that green seaweed increases the health of your arteries. In fact, seaweeds in general are very healthy because of their iodine content, their mineral content, and now we know they enhance your artery health. So never turn down a good seaweed salad if you have the opportunity. Well, we're done for this episode of the Kahn Chronicle. Thank you from the Kahn Center for Cardiac Longevity in Bingham Farms, Michigan. Thank you for visiting drjoelkahn.com. And have a healthy day.